Welcome, everyone. In today's tutorial, we'll be creating a hovering cube over a snowy landscape. Let's get started. Start by creating a regular hexagon using the polygon tool. Select the polygon tool. Change the number of sides to 6. While holding the shift key, create a regular hexagon. Next, create the left side surface of the cube. Use the rectangle tool and skew function to create the left side surface of the cube. For better visibility, change its color. Next, create the right side surface of the cube by duplicating the left side and flipping it horizontally. Use the pen tool to create the top surface of the cube. Ensure the snap function is on for better guidance while using the pen tool. Change its color. You can now delete or hide the initial hexagon. Create 3 duplicates of the landscape by pressing Ctrl plus J. Then, create a clipping mask of these duplicates with the cube surfaces by dragging the image onto the shapes one by one. Rename layers for better organization. Select the clipping image of the top layer. Rotate it 180 degrees. Move it upwards to get the reflection of the sky. Select the clipping image of the right side. Move it left and upwards to get the reflection of the snow from the bottom right corner. Select the clipping image of the left side. Move it right and upwards to get the reflection of the snow from the bottom left corner. To remove the edge colors from the cube surfaces, remove the fill color from the shape layers. To make the sides look like glossy reflective surfaces, add a curves adjustment to each layer. Select the top surface and press Ctrl plus M to add curves adjustment. In the curves adjustment panel, pull down the highlight node and pull up the shadows node. Close the curves adjustment panel and apply the same curves adjustment to the right and left side surfaces. Apply a 2px Gaussian blur to each side surface. If the edges of the cube become blurry, check the Preserve Alpha option in the Blur panel. To make the cube look more realistic, darken the edges of the top and right sides. Add a curves adjustment layer to the top side and drag the curve from the middle downwards to darken it. Invert the curve by pressing Ctrl plus Y. Select the brush tool. Ensure the colors are black and white in the color swatch switcher. Choose white and paint the edges and corners dark with a soft brush. Repeat this process for the right side surface. Since the sun is on the left side in this image, add a lighting live filter to the left surface. Adjust the lighting lines according to the light source. Increase the ambient light if needed. With the cube complete, let's create a realistic shadow. Select all cube surface layers. Create a group by pressing Ctrl plus G. Create a new pixel layer. And while the pixel layer is selected, hold the Ctrl key and click on the group to create a selection of the cube. Select the brush tool. Choose a shadow color from the image using the eyedropper tool. Paint inside the selection. Deselect the selection using Ctrl plus D. Move the painted layer downwards. Since the cube is floating, the shadow should not be attached to the cube. Adjust this shadow according to the sun using the perspective tool. And click Apply after adjusting. Decrease the opacity of the shadow layer. Apply a depth of field blur. Move the center of the field outside the shadow layer. Increase the blur radius to 100 pixels. Move the inner circle of the field near the top of the shadow. Move the outer circle of the field to the center of the shadow layer. Create a mask of the shadow layer. Choose the gradient tool and draw a linear black and white gradient from top to bottom. This makes the shadow darker at the top and lighter at the bottom. And there you have it. Your hovering cube over a snowy landscape is complete. Thanks for watching.